Good morning. Are we? Oh. It's a good morning on this beautiful Sunday morning. Thank you all for joining us. And if you're a visitor, thank you for coming. If you're today, the worship team is conducting the service. Reverend Siddiqui is taking a well and deserved rest, and we hope she's having a good holiday. Please join me in the start of our service with the call to worship. Come, let us worship with joy and excitement.
We come to praise God's glorious name.
Let us sing with enthusiasm, pray with openness, and listen with anticipation.
We gather on this day to rejoice for this day that the Lord has made.
Please stand if you are able for our gathering hymn, Voices United 412, This Is the Day. Join me in the acknowledgement of the land. We here at Sharon Hope United Church sit on the traditional lands of the Anishinaabe, the Haudenosaunee, and Wendat nations, land covered by the Dish with One Spoon Wampum Covenant. We give thanks for their stewardship of the land, continuing that tradition to care for this land for the generations to come. And the prayer of approach, if you would join me in that. Creator God, open our hearts and our minds to see your hand at work in the splendor of creation and the beauty of human life. We know that you are with us, whispering in the clover, floating with the butterflies, chattering with the birds. Help us to cherish the gifts that surround us, to share our blessings with others, and experience the joy and light in your presence. Sometimes the gifts of the season call to us, but often call us away from you. There are lakes to be explored, highways to travel, campsites to enjoy, rivers to fish, and people to visit. We can be totally caught up in our activities, wrapped up in our pleasures, that the thought of you and others is far from our minds. Forgive us. Hear the good news. We are loved unconditionally. We are forgiven abundantly. We are called endlessly. Thanks be to God. Amen. We'll sing Voices United 958 in our response. Alle, alle, alle. Passing of the peace, if you would say good morning to your neighbors all around you. And now we will sing more Voices 30. It's a song of praise to the Maker. Thank you. morning. This morning's responsive reading is Psalm 148 in Voices United 871. This morning, we're going to read it responsively and sing the refrain. Donna will start with the refrain. Praise God from the heavens, give praise in the heights. Give praise, all you angels. Praise God, all you hosts.
Praise God, sun and moon. Give praise, stars and lights. Praise God, farthest heavens, and all waters beyond heaven.
Let all things praise the Holy One at whose command they were created, who established them for all time, setting bounds which cannot be passed.
Praise God from the earth, great sea creatures and ocean depths, lightning and hail, snow and frost, gales that obey God's decree.
All mountains and hills, all fruit trees and cedars, all wild animals and cattle, creatures winged and earthbound.
Sovereigns who rule earth and its people, all who govern and judge this world, young men and women alike, old people and children together.
All things praise the name of God, the name above every other, whose splendor covers heaven and earth.
You give strength to your people, songs of praise to your faithful, to Israel, the people dear to your heart.
Now please turn to Voices United 245, Praise the Lord with the Sound of Trumpet.
Thank you.
see this one came off. Well, I hope I picked enough fruit and vegetables for dinner. I've got 2 carrots, 2 potatoes, a red pepper, apples, and limes. And I guess that's all I brought. So I hope this will be enough. As far as I know, there's only going to be 2 of us for dinner. But we never know about Lazarus. He's on the road so much of the time, we never know when he's going to show up for dinner. So I always make a little extra. Mary, did Lassie say anything to you about not coming home or coming home tonight for dinner?
No, not to me. He was gone before I got up.
You know the story about Lazarus, our brother. But just in case you don't, I'm going to tell you. Lazarus decided to follow this teacher whose name is Jesus. And he was going around the countryside, and then he came home and he became ill. Now, we don't know what would happen to him, but in a very short time, Lazarus died. And we were so sad.
I just couldn't believe it. It just came out of nowhere. How could this happen to our beautiful, healthy brother?
And so he called for Jesus. We sent a message. Now, of course, at that point, there were no iPads or no cell phones. So it took somebody a few days to find him. But Jesus didn't come. And Lazarus died.
We were so sad. I was like, why couldn't Jesus have come and been with us? He could have, we just knew he could have done something.
But then, this is what happened. Jesus did come. And I went and met him at the edge of town because that's where the cave was that we had buried Lazarus in. And we put a stone over the front of it. But Mary was sitting at home weeping.
Like usual. Nothing wrong with reading.
No, but she was weeping and weeping and weeping, and some of her friends with us. So when Jesus saw me, he said, someone go and find Mary.
And they came and got me, and I didn't know why I should go with them. What could be done? Lazarus was dead. We were so sad, but I went.
And I said to Jesus, if you had come, you could have healed him and he wouldn't have passed away. And Jesus began to weep. He was so sad. And then he looked up to the sky and he talked to God. We weren't quite sure what he said, but he did talk to God. And then he said, open the stone from the tomb.
We said, oh.
It was a massive stone. Like it covered the entire opening of that cave. This was going to take a monumental effort. And for what?
Anyway, they did. Several men got together and they tugged and they tugged and they pulled the stone away. And we said, oh my goodness, he's been dead for 4 days. The stench is going to be awful when that stone comes away. But they did it anyway. And Jesus said, Lazarus, come out of the tomb.
And to our amazement, there he came. Of course, still wrapped up, but it was Lazarus.
And they took the cloths away from his face, and Lazarus began to speak. It was
a miracle.
A truly miracle.
We couldn't believe it.
And nor could anybody else that were there. They said, I don't believe what I see, but maybe
I saw it. I know he was dead, and now he is alive. So this was a true miracle.
No. Hello. Hey, Lassie. Oh, that would be lovely. Which night this week is he coming to dinner? Oh, okay. I'll tell Martha. Bye. Mwah.
What did he say?
Oh, so Jesus and his friends are coming for dinner tonight. They're in Mount Albert right now. Then they're going to Queensville and then coming here. Isn't that wonderful?
You have to be kidding. They're coming for dinner tonight? How many friends? And are all of his disciples coming?
I don't know.
Wow. He could be here in a couple of hours. No time to put up the sign-up sheets for people to sign to bring food. No time to get in touch with Cheryl to organize the kitchen. Oh, I don't know. I can't have time to bake a pie or a cake. And we don't even know how many people are coming. Oh, my goodness sakes. What kind of potatoes? Scalloped or baked? I hope I picked enough fruit for tonight. And I'm not sure about 2 carrots and 2 potatoes. And we only have 1 bottle of wine. I wonder if that will be enough.
Oh, Martha, don't worry so. Remember that wedding at Cana that we attended? They ran short of wine. And then they served something that looked like water. But, oh my gosh, it was delicious. It tasted like the best wine I'd ever had.
Well, okay. I'll try to relax. There you go. Mary, is there a clean tablecloth?
Let me check. How about that one?
We can't use that one. It's all creased. It's probably been in there for 60 years. It was a wedding present for me.
Well, I have this one.
Okay, let's try it. Can't relax. There's so much cleaning to do. I have to do the dusting and she just sits there and never helps. And so the bottom of the seat's always okay, but around the edges kind of gets dusty sometimes. I dusted so hard my duster fell apart. And the silver needs to be polished. And the glasses need to be washed, besides getting the food ready. And Mary, do you think you could put that tablecloth on so it's straighter? Guess not. Guess we'll have to keep it like that. What is that you're reading? You're always reading those books from the church, never helping me.
Well, Mary, I will tell you what Jesus said. It is in the Bible. Don't worry about food. Life is more important than that. Think of the birds. They don't plant seeds or gather a harvest, and they don't have a storerooms or barns. God feeds them. Human beings are worth more than birds. Can any of us live longer by worrying? You must not make yourself upset or by worrying, but we will eat about worrying about what we will eat or drink. Our Creator knows that we need these things. God will provide for us.
The phone's ringing again. The meeting in Queensville's almost over, and they're going to be leaving soon. Lazarus, hop on your bike and go to Vince's and pick up something for dessert. They'll soon be here. And all the disciples are with him. We need to ask some of our church friends to help out because we're never going to have this food ready. Mary, phone Tenley Kelly. She makes good sourdough bread. Will you see if she's happened to make any bread today so that we could maybe have at least some bread?
Just let me check. Ten. It's Mary. Can you make some sourdough bread today? I know you've always got that stuff on the go. Do you think that would be possible? And could you bring it over as soon as it's ready? Martha's having a little, meltdown here. Can you help us? Oh, perfect. Thank you. Come right over. Oh, you're so fast.
And here comes Betty. And what's Betty brought us?
That Tenley.
Thank you so much. Thank you for that. Now, I think, and Gay, what have you got? Gail, did you bring something? Well, thank you. And Bev seems to have something there too. And Jane, did you bring us anything? And what kind are they? Oh, yummy, thank you. And Lazarus, I hear Lazarus coming on his motorbike. Oh, good. You went to Vince's and you got scones. Thank you. They're my favorite.
Awesome, Laz.
And Lazarus knows they're my favorite. He buys them for me at Cobb's usually, but this time he got them at Vince's. So that's really good. Thank you very much, Lazarus. And thank everybody.
You've all been so generous and helpful.
And I'm sure with this other fruit that we have here, we will have enough. We will make it enough, or else we ask Jesus for help. Why did I get in such a fuss? Sometimes I think I'm like a camera on the wrong setting, just a little bit out of focus, and need to have some more balance in our lives. Both of us need more balance in our lives. Between actions, words, and sitting reading to find out what other people have said. Look, here they come. Here come Jesus and the disciples. Come in. Come in and sit down, for you are a part of the family. And so, our next hymn will be, come in and sit down. Voices United, 395.
Thank you.
Please be seated. The story of Mary and Martha demonstrates how important it is for everyone to be helpful, to be caring, and to cooperate in times when we really need it. When dinner goes from 2 to 14 people, we need to be able to help each other out. And we will do that as we give our offering. You give to us abundantly. We now return some of these gifts to you. May they bring joy and hope and hospitality to others in our local church and larger community. Bless these gifts. Amen. And we'll sing, "I'm Going to Live So God Can Use Me," while you are giving your gifts. You have given to us abundantly. We now return some of these gifts to you. May they bring joy and hope and hospitality to others in our local church and larger community. Bless these gifts. Amen. And now maybe you'd like a stretch to stand up, and we will sing Voices United 595, the Servant Song. We are pilgrims.
Thank you.
be seated. We say the prayers of the people. Life-giving God, we give thanks for all the wonders of creation, for the color and design of this magnificent universe, and for the harmonious symphony of the sights and sounds of summer.
God of hospitality, we thank you for this church, not just the building, but for all the people who are part of this faith community. Be with us as we begin another week. We are part of the wider United Church. We are called to love and serve others.
Help us to be like Martha and Mary and show hospitality. We give thanks for all who are willing to share their time and their talents.
We live in a land of abundance. Help us to reach out to others in need.
Dear God, plant a seed of hope in those who are hungry and are overwhelmed by the uncertainty of the future.
Plant a seed of hope in those who face daily violence and live in war-torn countries.
Plant a seed of hope in those who face health problems or are saddened by the loss of a loved one. Be with them and give them strength, faith, and courage.
Plant a seed of hope in all those who strive to bring peace. May their commitment and sacrifice help promote just and peaceful relationships to innocent people.
Help us to remember that small things count. One smile can be the beginning of a friendship. One candle can bring light to a dark room. One hug or one touch can bring comfort and warmth.
One small contribution of time, talent, or money can make a difference. Help us to be hospitable and to understand the needs of our neighbors and friends wherever they live. Show us how to reach out and give support to those who need comfort, hope, and care.
Be with all those who are in positions of leadership throughout the world. Temper their tongues and fill their minds and hearts with understanding and concern for all people.
Creator God, hear our prayers, brothers, our community, and our world.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, forever and ever. Amen. Our closing hymn is Voices United 884. You shall go out with joy, and remember what the last word of that title is. Joy. Thank you. So let's go out with joy.
Thank you.
wonderful. You may be seated. And just before I give the blessing, I'd like to thank everyone who helped today. This was a real effort in coordination and cooperation. And I'd just like to thank all who participated. Thank you. Leave from here with joy in your heart, a song of your lips, a smile on your face, knowing you are surrounded by God's good grace, your time and your talents willing to share. By your actions and love, show others you care. Walk with confidence and hope each and every day, knowing the Creator walks with you each step of the way. And now, may the God of hope, peace, love, and joy go with you as we sing Voices United, 424. May the God of hope. Donna's going to play us a little ditty now. I don't know what it is.